hidden, and thieves break in to steal them.
No.
Store your treasures in heaven. There's no moths, no rust, and no thieves to break in to steal them. For where your treasure is, so will your heart be also.
Fetch me my robe, my best one, and put a ring on his finger and shoes on his feet.
and bring the fatted calf and kill it. A nice kosher one. And let us have a feast to celebrate this happy day. For this my son was dead and has come back to life, was lost and is found.
And the festivities begin.
Now the elder son was out on the farm working. And on his way back, as he was approaching the house, he heard music and dancing. He called to one of the servants. And asked him what it meant. The servant said,
"Wait, your sister. Your sister's come in from out of town. No, not your sister. Your brother-in-law. Your brother's come home from Detroit.
No, you ain't got no brother-in-law.
Your cousin.
You ain't got no cousin neither.
Your brother's come back.
Your daddy was real happy.
He sent them boys down there to get a fatty calf, and they killed it. And they up there having a big time.
Are you through, Tim?
Yeah.
But the brother was irritated.
Oh, give me a break, okay?
All right, he was pretty damn mad and refused to go into the house. The father came out and pleaded with him, but he retorted, saying,
"You know I've worked for you all these years and never once disobeyed your orders, but you didn't give me so much as a kid to roast with my friends. But once this other son of yours comes back after running through your money with his women, you roast the fatted calf for him." "Oh, my boy,"
said the father,
"you have always been with me, and everything I have is yours. Now, how could we help but to celebrate this happy day? This brother of yours was dead and has come back to life, metaphorically speaking, was lost and is found."
"Come on, Lee."
"Oh, Jesus, don't make me."
"Oh, you can do better than that."
"Yay!"
"So therefore I ask you, is there a man among you who would offer a son a stone when he asked for bread?"
"Is there a man among you who would offer his son a stone when he asked for bread?"
"A snake if he asked for fish?"
"No."
Well, if you now,
bad as you are,
now know how to give your children what is good for them. How much more will your heavenly Father give good things?"
Good things. Yeah.
"To those who ask for them, always treat others. As you would have them treat you."
Yeah.
Well, that is the law and the prophets.
The law.